All right, now it's time to build the front-end portion of our application, so let's get right to it. Let's start here in our source folder, which is where our front-end is, and we'll just start with app.js. Let's start with some cleanup. We don't need this constructor, and we actually don't need this method here either. They come by default with the boilerplate project, and we don't need those. We're not going to be making an Ajax call here. This is a pretty dumb component. And then let's replace the default markup that we have with some new markup. So we'll have an H1, which will be basically our title. It says heroes. And then below that, let's create something called a header bar, which is just an empty div with a nice blue bar. And then below that, this is where all of our heroes. So pretty much the application is going to go here. And I'm calling it heroes for now because that's going to be the main wrapping component. And I'm going to add some CSS in. I'm just copying and pasting this in. You can get this from the GitHub project. Let's collapse our bar. And then let's check and see what this looks like so far in the browser. Okay, starting to look pretty good. We got a title, we got a bar. We're ready to build out our list of heroes over here on the side. So let's do that. I'm gonna come over and I'm gonna create a components folder where we're gonna put all of our components. And then inside of that, create a new component and call it heroes. Now inside the heroes component, we're gonna need to import React and component. All right, so let's start with a component class, and we're just gonna call it heroes, and then we're gonna go ahead and set the initial state of heroes to be an empty array. This is where we're gonna stuff the return from our Ajax call to display on the page here, and then down here, let's start writing our JSX. So we'll have an empty div, and inside of that, an onward list of heroes, where we're gonna list out all of the heroes. Those will go here, and then below that, let's have an edit area. Perfect. And then our edit form goes here. So we'll just put some comments there. Now let's go ahead and actually get the heroes so that we can see them listed out here. So to do that, and actually before we can do that, we need to actually have some data. So let's jump over to our index file up here. Let's modify this route just a little bit. So let's call this heroes. And instead of welcome to express, let's just say const heroes, and that's going to be an array. And then let's return one. So a hero has an ID, a name, so I'm gonna use the tick because that's my favorite, and saying, what's the tick saying? Spoon! I have no idea why, but that's what it is. If you've ever seen the tick before, that makes sense to you. If not, that's complete nonsense. So we'll send back our heroes, and we wanna do res.json because we wanna send back some JSON. Cool, and let's restart the server, and then let's test this out and make sure this works. So we'll jump over to the browser. Remember, Express is running on port 3001, so we can say API heroes, and we should get back. Yep, we do. There's our JSON. So we're ready to consume this and display it over here. So let's do that. We can hop over to our heroes file, and we can just sort of list out our heroes here. So what we could do is say this.state .heroes and map. And map will loop over our heroes object, and we can work with each individual hero in that collection. And then we could have just a list item that has the hero name. Let's just do this for simplicity at the moment, then we'll start to build this out more. And then up here, we need to actually make our Ajax call. So let's do that. I'm gonna use a component did mount method. So our component's mounted, it's ready to go. And we use the fetch API to call /API/heroes, which returns a promise, and we get a result. We'll take that result, turn it into JSON, which is a built-in method on fetch. And that gives us yet another promise, which has our actual JSON in it. And then in there, we can say this.setState and then heroes is equal to our JSON. Okay, so we're making the API call, we're turning the result into JSON, and then we're taking the JSON, which is the array, and we're putting it into the state. And then we're looping over the state and listing out the heroes. Let's go ahead and add this component to our app.js file since we're done here. And let's go ahead and put it in. So we'll just say, we can say heroes, and it'll automatically get pulled in and imported up here at the top. Cool. All right, now let's go back and check out our application, and we're pulling in our item. So if we added another item, it would show down below this. Let's go ahead and continue to build this out. And again, we don't wanna put all of this here. Let's actually make this into its own component. So we'll pull this out, and I'm gonna do a new file here, and let's go ahead and save it. I'm just gonna call it hero.js, and we'll put it inside of the source components here. We'll just save it right there. Then we need to pull in React, and we actually don't need component, we just need React. And this is gonna be a stateless component. And we're gonna call it hero. and we'll build out the innards of this thing, and we'll have a list item, and that list item will contain a delete button, so we can delete the hero. And it will contain an element which has all the hero properties on it. So we'll call that hero element. And then inside of that, we're going to have a badge, which will display the ID. And then we can just copy option shift, copy these three rows down. We can change this to name, and we can change this to sing. Okay. And then up here, we're going to look at props.hero, which we haven't created yet, the ID. And then let's copy this in as well. And actually, I should have done that and then copied the line down. It would have been a little bit faster here. And then we'll update the name. And we'll update the saying. Okay, we're pretty much ready to go here, other than the fact that we need to add in properties. So let's add in props up here, otherwise we won't be able to read them. And we're ready to use this component in our heroes component. So let's go back, and we can just do return, and we can say hero. We'll just let it pull in our hero component automatically. If you remember, it does that up at the top. And then we need to pass in that props, that heroes, props.hero right there. And then we'll just say it's equal to hero. Okay. If we do this and nothing else, this should work just fine. So if we go back over to our application, and oops, made a little bit of a typo there. So let's go ahead and fix that. So it's not props.hero, it's not props.name, it's props.hero.name and props.hero.saying. And now we're looking a whole lot better. Cool. All right, so the next thing we need to do is add in the ability to edit this item. So that's what we'll be doing next. Now, what we want to happen is when we click this item, we want an edit form to show up, and we want this to be highlighted and the edit form to contain the data from this item. So the first thing we need to do is actually handle the select from this item here. So let's jump back over here, and I'm gonna go back to the heroes component. And in fact, I'm gonna go, let me move this to the side, and let's close everything but this. Stay focused here. And what we need to do is we need to pass in a basically a click event handler for this hero. So when we click on a hero, we can handle the event. So first, let's just add that event here. And we'll call it handle select. And then that's going to receive a hero. So when we click on this hero element, any hero element, it will handle the select and pass that hero into the select event. And we also need to go ahead and start with a constructor here, because we're going to be using events and we're going to need to bind the context to those events. So bear with me here. Let's create a constructor, and then inside of that we'll call super, and then we'll just add our state back on. And then the next thing we want to do is we want to bind. So we'll say this.handleSelect equals this.handleSelect.bind this. And the reason why we do that is so that inside of our function here, this has an actual value. If we don't do the bind up here, then this will be unknown. And that is not a limitation of React, but a limitation of ES6 classes, just the way it is. So now when we handle the select, what we want to do is we want to go ahead and set a selected hero. So we're gonna do this.setState, and we're gonna do selected hero, and set that to hero right here. Now, once we've set the selected hero, we need to show this edit area form, which we haven't created yet. So let's do that now. I'm gonna open up a new file, and we'll save it, and we'll call it edit hero, and we'll put it in the source and the components, and let's give it the right file extension. There we go, and then let's import React. And again, this is gonna be a stateless component, and it's gonna be called edit hero. Okay, and we're gonna put our edit form here, and I'm actually gonna copy this in because it's a little bit lengthy. Okay, so let's look at this markup because there seems to be a lot of it. It's not that bad, but let's go through it. We're gonna look at the selected hero, and if there is a selected hero, then we're gonna return the enough markup to create the edit form. If we scroll down, the else condition is to return an empty div. So we're only gonna show the edit form when there is a hero selected. That's all that's doing. And then we're gonna loop through the edit fields, and on the ID portion, we're gonna look at the props and say, are we adding a hero? This is a Boolean value that we haven't created yet. If so, then allow the user to change the ID. If not, then the ID will just be a label. And then as we move down the form, we're gonna have two more inputs, one for name and one for saying. And the value will be the selected hero name and saying. So we're bound to the selected hero. So when we change the selected hero in this form, the selected hero object's going to change, and that's what we're gonna eventually pass back to the database. And then we're handling the on change of inputs, because this is how forms work in React. These are controlled inputs. So we're actually gonna have to handle the change of these inputs so that we can make sure that our selected hero changes along with those inputs when they change. So let's go ahead and build this out in our heroes file where we're actually going to consume this edit hero component. So let's go back here and we'll add in edit hero as we've done before many times. And then we need several different things here. The first thing we need here is adding hero. Adding hero is a Boolean that tells us whether or not we're adding a hero or editing a hero. We're going to set that equal to this.state.addingHero. And that doesn't exist. So let's go ahead and add that to our initial state up here. So we'll say heroes and adding hero by default will be false. Okay. Now the next thing that we need to do is we need to pass in the selected hero. So we'll say selected hero. And that's going to be equal to this.state.selectedHero. And if you remember on our select event up here, we're actually setting that selected hero to the hero when a hero is selected. Now the next thing we need to do is we need to handle the onChange event of those inputs. So we're going to go ahead and do onChange, and we're going to have an event called this.handleChange. Doesn't exist yet, we'll create that in a moment. We've also got an onSave event in that form, so we'll do this.handleSave, and we've got a cancel event, so onCancel equals this.handleCancel. Okay, let's go ahead and add these events in up here. And I'm just gonna go ahead and, so you don't have to watch me type all this, I'm just gonna go ahead and put them in and then I'll be right back with you. All right, I've added those in, here's all the events, and I just stubbed them out, I haven't coded anything, so you didn't miss anything. And then, of course, they've been added in down here. So let's go ahead and take a look at the application. Still nothing is happening here, and that's because we're not handling the click. We haven't wired this up, and we need to do that in this hero component. So what we need to do is pass in an event here. So we're gonna pass in the, handle select is what we called it. So we're gonna say onSelect equals handle select. And now that we're passing an onSelect prop, we need to do something with that prop. So let's go over to our hero file, and let's go ahead and handle that. So in the list item, each time we have a click, an onClick in the list item here, we need to handle that. And I'm gonna copy this in. All right, so onClick, we're going to call the onSelect from our props and we're going to pass in the currently selected hero. And then the other thing that we need to do is we need to set a class name so that we know that this item, when it's selected, stays highlighted. So we'll do that and I'll copy that in. All right, here we go on this line. We've got the class name and the class looks at the hero and compares that to the selected hero. And if those two things are the same, then it applies a selected class. If they're not, then there is no class. So one last thing over on heroes, we need to actually pass in our selected hero because we're not doing that yet. So let's do selected hero equals this.state.selectedHero. Okay, perfect. Save that. I'll get some formatting. We're looking good. All right, let's jump over to our application and have a look. Oh, and we've got a silly error here. This needs to be this.handleSelect. All right, and now if we click on one of these, we see the edit form and the item stays highlighted. So the next thing we need to do is wire up the cancel button because that doesn't currently do anything. So let's go back and do that. In this method, all we have to do is say this.setState and we're gonna say the selected hero and we're just gonna set it to null because there's no longer a selected hero. And what that will do is reset the form. So if we click this, now we say cancel and we go back, right? This is no longer highlighted and the form goes away. Perfect. Now notice in our edit form, we can't actually edit this form. So I can type all day, but these inputs are not accepting that. And that's because these are controlled inputs. So we need to handle the change. And we've already specified that here on the onChange. So we've already got a method waiting to be implemented here. So let's do that. In the handleChange, what we wanna do is first we wanna get a reference to the currently selected hero. So we're gonna say let selectedHero equal this.state.selectedHero. Because the things in the state are immutable, means you can't change them. So in order to change it, we have to make a copy, change the copy, and then put it back. This is generally considered a good thing because it makes it so that you can't change the state really without very explicitly doing so. And now we want to change either the name or the saying of the selected hero based on which input changed. But how do we know which input changed? They're all calling the same event. Well, we're gonna pass in an event object, and that's already being passed in. And then what we'll do is we'll use array notation on the selected hero. So we'll look at the event target.name. So if we come back over and look at our event targets, you can see that we have our event target name is set to name, and name is set to saying here. So when this happens, this will be selected hero dot either saying or name, depending on which event got passed in. and then we'll set it to the value of the input. So that's how we can use one event to handle multiple inputs. And then the last thing we want to do is just update the state. So this dot set state and selected hero equals selected hero. Okay, now that we've done that, let's go back over to our application, click on one, and now we can edit these fields, right? And you can see that as I make these changes, it makes the change over here on this side as well. All right, so we're good. Let's go ahead and implement the ability to add a new item. To do that, we're gonna need a button, so let's add one in. I've got one ready to go. And we need a handle enable add mode, so I'm gonna add that in. Okay, so I've added that in, both up top here, I've bound it, and down below, here's the method. And what we wanna do is we wanna set the state here, and we're gonna set two things. We're gonna set adding hero, because that's now true, and we're going to set the selected hero to a default value. So we're gonna give it all empty strings all the way across the board. And the reason why we're doing that is we're looking at this, both of these properties really. So selected hero, if we go back over to the form, see, if we don't pass a selected hero, we don't see this form at all. So we need to pass in a selected hero, otherwise we see nothing, because this is how we're controlling the visibility of the form. And then the Boolean just tells us we're in edit mode versus add mode. So now we click on the button, we get the form here. Now it's important to note that now that we've set the adding hero state here to true, whenever we cancel out, we need to make sure that we put that state back. So we need to say adding hero here is false. Now, once we've done that, we come back over. If we click, we do not get to edit the ID. If we add a new hero, we can edit the ID, which is exactly what we want. So handling all the different states that we might have here. Okay, now the last thing we need to do is just implement this delete and this save. But really, we need to wire those up to the database in order to do that. So we're on to Cosmos DB. We're ready to rock and roll. So let's go ahead and do that